In this video, we're given a simple pendulum released from rest at an angle of 5 degrees. We're also told the length of this thing is 1.2 meters. And we have two questions to answer. The first one is to find the time for the pendulum bob to reach its maximum speed. Now, with our knowledge of energy conservation, we know that the maximum speed happens at the lowest point for this pendulum. In other words, when it's passing through the equilibrium point, and that's actually 1/4 of a period into the motion. Then we're going to follow this up in part B by actually computing the maximum speed for the pendulum, and that's an energy conservation problem. So first, part A, I want to find the time it takes to get to the bottom of its path. And first, I just want to compute the period for the pendulum, like how long does it take to go all the way to the left and then come back to where it started. And the period for a pendulum is 2 pi square root L over G, and I'll post a link to the video where that was first derived. Note that we weren't given the mass for the pendulum bob, and we don't need it because the period of a simple pendulum is not mass dependent. So we plug in our length of 1.2 meters, and we'll use 9.8 for our approximate value of G. And to three significant digits, we get a period of about 2.20 seconds. Now again, the time to get from our original highest position down to the equilibrium position, that's exactly 1/4 of a period, because a period is a full oscillation all the way to the left and all the way back to the right. And we're just getting halfway to the left here, so a quarter period. So we're going to take this and divide by 4. In other words, 1/4 period is the time we're looking for. And to three significant digits, this gives us 0.550 seconds. So next we get into this energy conservation problem. We want to find the maximum speed for the pendulum bob, and that's going to happen at the lowest point on its path, which is at that equilibrium location. So we'll start by saying E initial is equal to E final. And if we put the zero of our y coordinate at the lowest point, then the initial energy is entirely gravitational potential energy. So we can write that as mg y initial. And our final energy is going to be entirely kinetic energy. So I have a 1/2 m v final squared. So note again that the m's are going to cancel here. And just solving this symbolically real quick, I find that v final is the square root of 2g y initial. So now we get into the complication of how to relate the initial height to the initial angle. So we're going to go ahead and mark where our origin is, in other words, the lowest point in the problem, and where the initial height is, and then do a little bit of trigonometry. So the lower line that I put in there is going to be the location of the center of mass of this pendulum bob when it's passing through the equilibrium point. And then the upper line is our initial y coordinate, and we'd like to relate that to the initial angle of 5 degrees. And there's a standard trick for this. We go ahead and look at the equilibrium location for the pendulum bob. And at that location, the distance from the attachment point of the string to the center of mass of the pendulum bob is just the length of the pendulum. That's L equals 1.2 meters. I'm just going to call that L for now. Then next, we're going to look at the distance from the attachment point of the string to this location right here. In other words, where the y coordinate is equal to our initial y coordinate for the pendulum bob. Well, now we're looking at a right triangle where the hypotenuse is the same value L, which is 1.2 meters. And the length we're trying to get here between the attachment point of the string and down here at this little yellow circle is just L times the cosine of 5 degrees. So that means the little height change that we're looking for here, the difference between y initial and y equals 0, is L minus L cosine 5 degrees. So with all that worked out, we're ready to solve the problem. I have V final is equal to 2G times Y initial, but Y initial is L minus L cosine 5 degrees. Let's go ahead and factor an L out while we're working. So we get 2GL times 1 minus cosine 5 degrees inside that square root. And we're ready to just plug in all our numbers. And again, we'll use an approximate value of 9.8 for G, and then L was 1.2 meters. And then I have this 1 minus cosine 5 degrees in there. And we're going to multiply all that stuff and take the square root. And when I run the numbers on this to three significant digits, I get 0.299 meters per second. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. Or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.